you need to push yourself to progress, and I did, admittedly a little bit too much, but it just wasn't my day. I flew through the air, hit a tree, head on, and that's when I blacked out. When I came round, I was stuck under a tree, tangled up in my bike. I had a lot of adrenaline in my body at that point, so I didn't really think there was anything wrong with me. In hospital, they doped me up with morphine and sent me on my way. I was a little bit worried that I couldn't feel anything in my arm. I was referred to a specialist down in Swansea. There he concluded from my scans that I had definitely tore two nerves clean off the spine. My first fears were actually true. I was paralysed from the neck down to fingertips in my left arm. In work, I got kicked off the tools. I had to come to the office because I couldn't operate the machinery that I needed to. I sold my downhill bike. It had to go. I had no use for it. I ended up spending most of my time wasting away in front of the TV. Things started to get to me. I'm not a negative person, but I just had to prove to myself that I can do the things I love. Went and pulled out an old bike from the back of the shed. It felt great again, felt like a kid, just pulling skids and popping off curbs, just brought a big smile to my face. I realised that if I put my mind to it, I had the potential to ride downhill again. A new bike's about £30, but it's still by no means light when you're riding with one. I use a sling to strap my arm up. It holds my arm close into my body, helps me with balance. I've been riding about a year now. I've had a fair few crashes. Some of them hurt, some of them I just hop back on the bike again. But you know what? I couldn't be happier.